So what's he going to be going through when we pick up the season?
I don't know.
Stuff.
His girlfriend's gone. Liam's girlfriend's gone. So I think that's a big issue for him. Because he's kind of alone now, you know. Doesn't have anyone to fall back on. I think he's getting closer and closer to becoming the leader of the pack, you know, with time. So I think he's kind of stressing out about that because he's taking, every season Liam takes on more responsibility. And I think that's going to always be a constant struggle, especially with his kind of anger disability kind of thing.
Yeah.
Not disability.
Is this upcoming second half of the season something that you really look forward to the fans getting to check out?
Yeah, I mean, I look forward to the fans seeing every season, but this is the last one. And it's just we all put everything into it, you know. We did, we really gave it our all. There's like a lot of, I've seen a lot of the stuff, and there's a lot of really good performances. And, I mean, it's ending the whole show, you know what I mean? So it's a little nerve-wracking because not everyone might like how it ends, you know? You don't know. So, but I think we killed this season, so I can't wait for everyone to see it.
What was it like having the gang all back together, having Tyler Belch and Jeremy?
It was great. I mean, we all have different storylines, you know? So we work at different times, we have different plots and stuff. But it was great just having them back on set. You know, I worked with Hecklin in season 4 a little bit, and I was there the day he wrapped, like, from the show. And then he came back, so it's just good to have the family back together, you know. And I've met Colton here and there, and I know Max and Charlie, and Max isn't back, but Charlie is, you know. So it's just good to have everyone back. It was, like, a really full, fun set this last season.
Does Liam team up with anyone that we won't expect him to?
I mean, with Theo. He's still teaming up with Theo. They kind of have a really funny relationship that we didn't... I don't think we anticipated it, like, for people to like it as much as they did in the last part of the season. But everyone does, so we just played on that. Where they wrote more stuff for me and Cody to do. And I think that's really... That's kind of the main... It's for Liam. It's Liam and Theo and Liam and Mason. It's pretty much kind of, you know, his thing, and then the rest of the group and everything. But I think really the only one is probably Theo.
Is your relationship with Mason going to grow even more kind of similar to how Scott and Styles kind of like really bonded over the course of the season and like the last 10 episodes?
Yeah, I'm trying to think of specific scenes that help me. I mean, it's kind of one of those things where, you know, I'm best friends with Kyler. We're best friends, like, you know, we're always together on and off the show. So I think as our relationship grows in our personal lives, our acting together grows as well. So I think each season we manage to make it more specific and more, our friendship on the show more interesting, you know what I mean? So I think even, there's a little bit more, like, coming together kind of stuff, like bonding moments, but even if they didn't write anything specifically for us, you know, whenever we act together, it's just more and more, just gets real, more and more real, you know what I mean?
It's like you've been writing more comedy for your character. Is that something you requested, or is it just kind of
come out? I didn't really request it, I don't think. Did I request it? No, I didn't request it. But I think kind of as we, you know, we've been doing the show, Jeff will write things here and there, and the writers will kind of like test stuff out, you know, like we'll give him a funny line, see if it works. And I think ever since I did that, I fell in a hole thing, that's like kind of when everyone really was like, oh, okay, he can be funny. So since then they've been writing more and more funny stuff, and I definitely have some really cool comedic moments in the last season that are going to be really funny that I'm excited for everyone to see.
Like, now that you've done a lot of comedic moments, maybe your next role could be more of a comedy role, or just anything that comes up.
I mean, I would love to do a comedy. I would love to do a comedic movie. It would be really fun. I don't know. I really do love comedy. I love awkward comedy, you know? Like, The Office is one of my favorite shows. and I think I pull a lot of my comedy from that show. I don't know, I think being awkward's really funny, so that's something that I've always played on. So maybe I can figure out a way to make that work, you know, in my career and do some more funny films, and I'd love to, but honestly, I would just do anything as long as the material's good, you know? That's all we actors care about is good material.
Looking back over the seasons, is there an episode that really is like Liam's defining episode?
There's going to be a lot of stuff this season I really like. This was like, this season that we just did was like the first one I really felt like Liam was like very adult and like very, the character was a little bit more respectable, you know what I mean? Like not in terms of like, Liam's always been a good character, but like in terms of just the tone, it's overall a lot more adult-like, I guess, and a lot more, I don't know, he just seems grown up really this season. And I think there's been all kinds of scenes that define Liam. I think that, I don't know. There's been a couple things, but I mean, he's always struggled with his anger. So that's kind of like the thing that he's not completely yet there yet. But I feel like this season is kind of setting him up to be... you know, it's kind of, I think this, what I'm trying to say is this season's really defining Liam as going forward now. It was a runabout, but
it was
we made it.
We made it. Did you guys find it exciting that you were kind of going back full circle to now, instead of fighting supernatural creatures, you're back to being hunted by hunters?
Dude, yeah, I mean, that's, I think in terms of the show, the way that they mapped it out, that's really cool, and I also think that... just as an actor, it was fun to do that because we played a lot on the, like, you know, in the last, the season before this, we had the beast, you know, which was fun, but that's like a big, like, animated character you have to, like, really act, whereas we got to work with all real people for the most part, and I don't know, it was a lot easier to play to, a lot closer to home, because it's kind of like, you know, if you see a gun... in real life, that's scary, and then you act that out, and that's also scary, where it's kind of hard to imagine, like, what would it be like if I see a beast in, like, real life, you know what I mean? You kind of have to do some tweaking in your brain to make that work for you, whereas, you know, running from someone shooting at you is a lot easier and more real to play. So I think for the actors, that was fun, going back to that, because I remember seeing the hunters in season one, and I think one and two, was it? And I was like, that would be cool. That'd be cool to do, you know. And the gunfights are fun to film and fun to shoot. So I think that's a really, I don't know. I like doing the real people. I don't know. There's something about it was a lot easier, and it's just fun to do.
What was the hardest goodbye for, like, which character?
The what?
The hardest goodbye.
You mean in real life?
Yeah.
The hardest, I don't know. It's going to be hard. I'm going to miss everybody, you know. I think I'm really going to miss, I worked with Tyler and Kylan the most, probably, and Cody. But I live really close to Cody, so I see him all the time. I live pretty close to Tyler. I think I'll probably miss Kylan the most because we have so much fun filming, and he lives like 2 hours away. So unless we're doing this kind of stuff, we still talk, but we don't see each other as much because of our physical locations. So I think I'll miss living with him because like he lived at my house while we were filming. So I'll miss that kind of roommate, like bachelor kind of, I don't know, we were just like together 24/7 when we were filming. We were always driving the set together and stuff, so I think I'll miss that routine. But, I mean, I'm close to everybody on set, so it's not like I'm not going to see them. You know what I mean? I'm not too worried about that.
If we were to catch up with Liam in 10 years, what would he be doing?
I think I feel like he would get back together with his girlfriend. I think he would. I just really like that their relationship, so I think that would happen. I don't know, we didn't really explore too much like what Liam would be doing as a career, like as an adult, because I think because his character was kind of young and still on the show. But I think he's probably still in Beacon Hills. He's probably like either, I don't know what happens with Scott. I don't know if he stays the alpha or what he does. So I'd say Liam's either right there beside him still, or Liam's the new leader. Because he really cares about the pack, and I think he wouldn't abandon them. I don't know. Maybe he's a mechanic. Maybe he's he works at the grocery store, and then he fights crime at night.
That's good.
Yeah. I like that. He's the manager at a local Beacon Hills grocery store.
Is there anything that you wanted to do on the show that you didn't get to do?
We do... No, we do so much stuff on the show. You know, we have comedy, horror, action, romance. We have everything. I think the one thing I would have liked to do more is the comedy, you know? I think that was really fun. And it's we're all so hyper on set and have so much fun, you know what I mean? So I feel like that would have been even more fun just to add on top of it. But we really do a little bit of everything. So I got a good taste of everything.